In the mid-19th century, Edinburgh was home to a boom in the whisky trade, owing to new laws allowing blending of the spirit. Today, Craig wants to give his guests a taste of his tipsy hotel package.
Welcome, guys.
Hey, so great.
Welcome,
John.
So, welcome, guys.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Craig.
So, as part of the whisky experience, the favourite part is tasting the whisky.
Bring it on. Hey.
Oh, right up my street.
I'm really looking forward to the whisky taste.
I'm really excited to taste a few whiskies.
I bet you are.
Just a couple.
Whisky expert Hector is on hand to get them into the spirit of things.
First little trick, little secret. Take your hand, pop it over the top of your whiskey glass. Like, put some whiskey on your hand, put your whiskey back down, and rub your hands together like you would be washing your hands. And then smell your hands. Breathe in deeply. You get all the smells of the whiskey without that alcoholic burn. And that first whiskey should smell quite sweet.
I actually thought I could smell it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's the most common flavour in whiskey.
Yeah, that's just cleaned all the grained in dirt off my hands. I've never done putting the whiskey on your hand before, and it really worked for me.
Back in the bar, Hector is raising the bar.
The trick is to always angle your glass and understand that smell is layered. Top of the whiskey always smells fruity and floral. The middle will taste woody and spicy. The bottom's where the alcohol resides.
Unfortunately, I may have a large hooter, but my sense of smell is rubbish.
Yeah.
So all I'm getting is aftershave. I'm so sorry.
I think they did actually like the smell test. The way Hector sort of like came across how you can sort of like get different smells from different areas of the glass, I think they sort of like thoroughly enjoyed that.
Having Hector there as well, his knowledge, I've learned so much this afternoon.
Finally, it's time to take a sip.
Hold it in your mouth for 5 seconds. Move it around the palate. By moving it around, you remove the burn. Slange.
Being obviously an uneducated drinker, I would always get that burn.
Mm.
And just that little technique there, fabulous.
The one we're drinking now, it is actually sort of like a mellow whiskey. That's why I chose this one as the first one, so we can go into more like sort of like robust flavours.
But John's bitten off more than he can chew.
Hector, I've just had a new set of false teeth and all this swilling about, and it's dissolved the glue that's on my false teeth in. John's personality and his banter, his humour, is coming out more and more as we go through this process.
John doesn't need whiskey, though,
for
his sense of humour to come through.
As the malt makes its mark, Shona is keen to get to the bottom of Craig's barrel.
So can you come here, Craig, just booking as a bed and breakfast without the whisky experience?
Absolutely, Shona. Yeah, predominantly we run throughout the year as just like a normal guest house. And it's just like selected dates throughout the year that we offer guests a chance to sample Scotland's national drink by doing sort of like the whisky experience.
So what would it be if we were just booking in for bed and breakfast, for example?
So peak season, it ranges from about £90 to about £120 per night.
So I think ours was £169.
But you've got to bear in mind, we've got a double room, you've got 6 whiskies, you've obviously got the knowledge that Hector brings as well.
Yeah.
And in the morning, you get the full Scottish breakfast.
I think, Hector, you're priceless.
That's extremely kind of you.
And with the rate ruminated, the afternoon ends with the competition being contemplated.
I think the value for money is exceptional, really. He's got a fabulous product, for sure.
And I'm sure he will do very, very well.
Yes.